something about the name of Jesus. Amen. Can we just call on the name of Jesus this morning? Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. When you don't know what else to say and when you don't know what else to pray, you can just say Jesus. Hallelujah. And there's something about the name of Jesus. Amen. When we call on him, he'll show up. When we call on him, he'll answer. Hallelujah. When we call on him, he will deliver. There's something about the name of Jesus. And so we came this morning to worship him this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's Youth Sunday, and I'm excited. I love to see our youth just worship and give God glory. So I'm so excited about what he's going to do in and through them this morning. Because I believe that he is changing lives at the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. And that's why we got to pray. Because when we call on him, he'll work in the midst of what they're going through. Amen. So we give God glory this morning just for being God in this place and in this house. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Can we just give him a hand clap of praise this morning? Can we just tell him, God, we appreciate you. God, we thank you for breath in our bodies. We thank you for strength in our limbs this morning. We thank you, God, that we can call on you. Hallelujah. We thank you for the freedom to worship. Hallelujah. We thank you for the freedom to praise you today, and we give you glory in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. I'll be followed by Antonasia this morning with our scripture. Thank you, Lord.
Praise ye the Lord, praise ye the name of the Lord. Praise him, O ye servants of the Lord, ye that stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God. Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good. Sing praise unto his name, for his pleasant.
Amen.
Amen. We'll be followed with Michelle with the prayer. Amen.
Please bow your head. Dear Lord, I thank you for still being here today and everyone that's here. And those who are not here today, please let them to tune in, coming here or online. Please let this time be where they can have a stronger connection with you and be strengthened them according to your word. Help any illness, help the sick recover, and help them know that you love them and you care for them. And let everyone this peace in the nation and strengthen everyone around them to know that it's okay and it's all right and you'll get with us and you will never forsake us. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to ask that the youth come up and bless us this morning in worship and in song. And I heard Antonasia read that it's pleasant to praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Some verses say that it's calmly, it's upright. Hallelujah. That's what the righteous should do, is bless the name of the Lord. So if our youth would come on at this time. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's all working out for our good. Amen.
He's never failing.
He's working for me.
And no, I can't see how.
are the voice. We are your song. You are God. We are your people. You are the light. We stand it on.
Good morning, saints. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. It's a blessing to be in the house. This is the day that the youth is going to be acknowledged you pastors coming with an awesome word from the Lord today. So it's a blessing to see each and every one of you in the house this morning. Those that are listening by via internet, Facebook, YouTube, Skype, however you're listening to us, it's a blessing to be here this morning. But I just come this morning with some concern. And the concern is this demon of invisibility, he's focusing on our youth now, because if he can get rid of the youth, he can change the nation. And right now, I was looking at news this morning where the kids are meeting up in the food court at the malls, and they're shooting one at the other. And so the fighting is coming together, where they're coming together as different gang members and different cliques. They're going to a public place where they can begin to fight one and the other. So that concerns me, saints, because I want us to understand if the enemy can take our youth away, he can change the nation. And so since school is doing the things that it has been doing since we have this pandemic moving the way that it has, the kids are staying in the house right now. We're having a surge with obesity. Our children, our younger folks are beginning to face obesity. So parents, I want to urge you to get them outside, get them in the yard, run around the yard, do something, because once that begins to happen, once those genes get inside of our children with obesity, now you're looking at different illnesses that's going to happen, be it diabetes or be it different things that's going to come from this obesity. So parents, don't just let your children sit in the house and run their computer. Make them do some push-ups. Make them do some exercise. Make them do some things that can keep their weight down in the name of Jesus. And so this demon, he's trying to deceive our young folks. He's trying to make them think that, you know, nothing doesn't matter. The youth, the mindset of this world will change. COVID, and I want to change something right quick, and then I go back to that. COVID-19 testing. We have COVID-19 testing via the VFW site this Tuesday. The one that's on Ramsey Street, and we'll be there from 1 to 7. The testing is free, no registration needed. All you need to do is just come down, bring your ID card so that we can check you and make sure all is well with you. You say who you are. And then the COVID-19 test at VFW. And then after that, we'll move to Kingdom Impact Church, which is on Murchison Road. Same thing is happening on that Friday. So next Tuesday, next Friday, we have two free COVID-19 testing drive-through or walk-up. You just walk up, get your test free, and then from 5 to 7 days, we'll make sure that you know your results in the name of Jesus. So we said again, now that time will be from 1 to 7 o'clock, next Tuesday and next Friday. But now I want to get back to the children. Substance abuse is up. Our children is running towards a pastime of asking that adult in their life to purchase the alcohol that they need in order to make them feel some kind of way. And because of that, our children are getting more strung out. We have the Hampton Institute is right, they partnered in the parking lot with us. And I was talking with one of their members just yesterday, and he said they're getting more and more and more of our youth folks coming over receiving psychiatric treatment because of the substance abuse that now they are inundated in their life by us as adults who are allowing it to be purchased. So parents, I want us to just get more involved with that young folk and then get them involved with things. But this is my scare. Right now, gun violence is surging. Most of the time, Brother Graham, we were running behind toilet paper and we were running behind paper towels, but now we're running behind guns, Brother Graham. So we got to arm ourselves. And so that's what they're doing now. The bullets are in its red form. You can hardly find bullets now for your weapons because they're buying and buying and buying weapons. They're buying and buying and buying guns. And the thing with that is, this is the problem. A person that cannot purchase a handgun can go purchase a rifle. And once they purchase that rifle, they're still in the same category as a gun owner. So young folks, let's look at how this world is turning. And let's look at how we need to continue to pray and stay on the front lines for our youth. Because we don't want Satan to pull our youth in a direction that's now incarceration is their only way out, or death is their only way out. And death doesn't have to be from a gunshot, but it can be from these diseases that come with obesity. So I want us to just focus on our kids, begin to move on them. If you have not been getting on them about getting outside and do something, make them run around the yard, make them do push-ups, set a regimental time in your home to make your kids do exercise at least, and they at least need a vigorous workout for 20 minutes. And 20 minutes a day, either 20 minutes but three times a week, and then that'll get them to the point where we'll keep their heart rate running like it should be in the name of Jesus. And so my youth, so today is Youth Sunday. I just wanted to put some stats out about our youth so that they'll be armed and dangerous in the Lord to do the things that's going to combat what this demon is trying to do to us. Also, if our youth need something to do, tell them to come link up with Pastor Davis, and we can get outside in the churchyard and cut grass and cut hedges and pluck up stuff out the parking lot. I can get a visit. Thanks. I tell you, I have a visit for at least an hour and a half. And then when they get home, you ain't got to worry about them no more. They're going to lay it down. So tell them, if you need something to do, tell them link up with Pastor Davis on Saturday, 6 o'clock here at Embrace Hope. And I can get them busy for you. I keep them busy as we begin to go and cut hedges and trim trees and all of that stuff to keep them busy. Young folks like, sure, not me. Just make sure you get some sunscreen that you'll be protected. I just want to say thank God for all of you. It's such a blessing that you allow us to come back into the house of the Lord. It's just such a blessing. I just love the Lord's thanks. I could talk about it forever because I know without him, I would be here standing before you now. And so I just want to say thank you, God, for what you've already done. Yes. Our testimony that we have. And so, youth pastor, you ready? Amen. Come on up and give us the uncut version of the word of God. Tell us the truth and we'll love you for it. In the name of Jesus.
Glory to the name of Jesus. He is the living word. Amen. Anybody come for some bread this morning? Anybody come hungry this morning? Saying, Lord, I just need to hear from you again. Lord, I just need to feel your presence again. God, I need your touch again. Anybody come desiring God this morning? Amen. Amen. He is the living word. Amen. We give him glory and honor in this place today. And we thank him for what he's getting ready to do. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we glory in you this morning. You are our shelter. You are our refuge, God. You are our hiding place. And we come, God, just to be with you this morning. We come to hear from on high, God. We come to receive a right now word, God, for our minds, our bodies, souls, and our spirits. We come, God, that you might even chastise us in your love, God, that you can set us on a right path with you, God. We come to receive from your table this morning. And so we tell you, thank you, God, for the opportunity to even be seated with you, God, for the opportunity to hear your voice, God, for you said that your people hear your voice, and the voice of a stranger they will not follow. So I declare right now in the name of Jesus that every stopped up ear is loose in Jesus' name. I declare right now in the name of Jesus that every ear hears what the word of the Lord says. I declare right now in the name of Jesus that our mind, body, souls, and spirit lines up with the divine word for this hour. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. It's good to be in the house of the Lord again. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We just thank God. I know that God is working. Anybody know he's working? Sometimes I can't feel him. Sometimes I don't see him the way I want to see him, but I know that he's working. Amen. Amen. And so if you will, we're going to get right into the word this morning because that's just the way the Lord gave it to me. So if you'll go to 1 Timothy chapter 6. We're going to 1 Timothy chapter 6. And as I was looking back over scripture last night, the Lord had sent me to a scripture, and I just looked up and I said, Elder, the Lord is wonderful, because he'll give you the beginning of the thing and you don't know where he's going until you go seek him out. Uh-huh. And when I went to seek what he was saying to me, he showed me the end of the thing and it all connected together. And I just said, wow, God is just awesome. Yes, he is. And this morning, Pastor, even as you came, you didn't know that you laid the foundation for the title for the word today. And so I just thank God that he is in the place. Amen. Hallelujah. I thank God that he's in the place. We're going to 1 Timothy chapter 6, and we're going to go to verse 12. Amen. 1 Timothy chapter 6, starting at verse 12. Fight the good fight of faith. lay hold on eternal life, to which you were also called and have confessed the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Can I read that again?
Yeah.
Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, to which you were also called and have confessed the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. And the Lord had been speaking to me the word fight. And he is telling the body of Christ to fight. And so Pastor came up and he talked about how the youth are getting engaged and getting involved in different things, and they're carrying on and they're fighting in the natural realm. And the word of the Lord today is to fight. And specifically, he's telling us to fight for our faith. We know how to fight each other. We know how to fight on social media. We know how to fight with our words. If you good, like I can be sometimes, thank the Lord that he's working on me. I can fight with my attitude. I don't have to say a word, but you know I'm fighting with you. Amen. And so we have crafted and we know how to fight in the natural. And we know that God says we shouldn't be rivals. We shouldn't be fighting all the time in the natural. But this morning, God says, I need you to fight in the spirit realm.
Amen.
If you know how to fight in the natural, he says, I need you to fight for your faith. I need you to fight for what you say you believe in. I need you to fight for your identity in me. Too long have we let the enemy show up and say, you ain't going to be nothing, or you're never going to break that habit, or you're going to stay here. And instead of us saying, no, the word of the Lord says that all that call on the name be saved, we start agreeing with him. Yeah, I am ugly. I'm not fearfully and wonderfully made. You don't say that, but that's what you acknowledge when you look in the mirror and you begin to look down on yourself. You're saying that what God created is not worthy. And the Bible says he made everything beautiful in his time. So God said it's time for us to quit just accepting what the enemy has in the atmosphere and to fight the fight of faith. Fight. How do you fight? You fight by praying. You fight by reading your word. But the Lord is saying what's missing from all of that is the fight of faith. You first got to believe.
Yes.
We must believe what the Lord has said. We must read it and act as if we believe.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we'll read the word and we say, yes, amen, God, that was good. But then the next time something shows up, we act like we never heard from God. We act like he didn't bring us through last time, and the time before that, and the time before that, and the time before I knew him, and the time before that, and the time before that, and he showed up time and time again. He says, fight for your faith. Listen, I was sitting in bed. The Lord said, the enemy don't want your health. The enemy, yeah, COVID's out there, but that's not really what the enemy's after. The enemy don't want your marriage, even though it might be going through at times. The enemy does not want your job, even though you might be unemployed at the moment. What the enemy wants is your faith.
That's right.
Because if I can get you to doubt God, nothing else is going to take place. If I can get you to question whether he is who he says he is and whether he'll do what he says he'll do, the enemy doesn't have to do anything else because God can't move on unbelief. That's what the word says. Matter of fact, he tells us in James, he said, we can't be tossed to and fro. He says, those that are tossed to and fro are like the sea and should not expect to receive anything from God. That's what it says in James, the first chapter. So that tells me that I got to grab hold of faith. And when everything else is tossing and throwing, we got to remain to stay steadfast and say, but yet I believe. God, I don't understand it. I don't even like this place. I don't like the way it feels. I'm ready for things to change, but I believe. I believe your best. I believe your word. I believe that you said that all things are working together for my good. It's a tough place, but I am willing to fight for this faith. And there were some days, maybe, I don't know if it's been 3 or 4 weeks ago now, but I had one of the hardest attacks that I've had in a long time, and it wasn't physical. My health was good, and nothing in the house was going wrong, and I was just battling in my mind with the issue of faith.
Yes.
And I said, God, we done been around this mountain too long for me to question. And I'm not talking about faith, well, you know, God, you're going to bring the money. We all struggle sometimes, faith in you. I'm talking about the basic level of faith of are you God?
Mm-hmm.
And it shook me to my core because I've been in this thing too long and have seen him do too much and know that what he's done, no man could have done for me to be sitting somewhere saying, are you God? And it began to shake me, and I began to not understand it, and even my surroundings were feeling different. And finally, about the second weekend, I told Elder, I said, honey, I need you praying for me. I'm going through something, and I need you praying for me. And I didn't give him specifics. I just said, hey, I need you praying. And so I just kept, you know, I finally decided, God, you know, I don't know what this is. You know, I was still talking to him in my unbelief and in my question. I said, but I tell you what, I'm going to keep walking with you. I'm going to keep walking through you, because if he's God, guess what? He's going to show up. We can quit doubting God, because he proves himself, amen? And so sure enough, and I believe sometimes the Lord, those of us that are have certain giftings in the Lord, he'll allow you to go through and feel what his people are going through so that you can deliver what he's giving you to deliver, amen? And so I know that if I've been in this thing a while and I went through, there's some other folk that's going through saying, but is he God? And if you notice the way the enemy is working right now, that's what he wants to happen. Yeah. He wants the people to question, is there a God? Right. Is he who he says he is? Yeah. And so the Lord said, tell my people to fight for the faith. Amen. Now he began to share with me about that fight. He said, but you can't fight what you're butting up with. You can't fight to be delivered, but continue to walk in the dark. I'm not talking about stumbling. I'm talking about totally just walking the way you know you're not supposed to walk. If he says, hey, listen, if you sow to the flesh, of the flesh you're going to reap corruption, and you know that our overuse of alcohol is corroding your liver, you've got to forsake that, because he says, listen, you're going to be corrupted, and it won't be my fault.
That's right.
Yeah. Because you've chosen to sow to the flesh. If we know that cigarettes cloud up the lungs and cause trouble breathing and breaks down our immunity, and we're smoking and carrying on with other things as well, we have to understand that there is a cost. It doesn't mean God loves us any less. But what it means is that there is a consequence for the sin, because he's loving, but he's also a just God. And he says, that is my temple. He says, did you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost?
Right.
Hallelujah. We can't treat the temple of God any kind of way.
That's right.
Yeah, you know, we like to talk about that, but I heard Pastor say this morning, we got to get up and move around.
Right.
We got to get up and fight diabetes.
Right.
And the Bible says that faith without works is dead. So if I believe God don't supernaturally drop 35 pounds, I got to do some work to get 35 pounds to drop, amen?
Amen.
I got to get up and walk. I got to change the way I eat. I can pray to him every morning, but unless I get on the move and start doing those things that we already know to do, we must give God room to work. He said, fight the good fight of faith. He says, lay hold to eternal life, because that's what's at stake, and not just your life. If we, the believers, he said, in the last days, the enemy would deceive even the very elect if it were possible. So you got to stand. You got to stand when you don't feel like it. You got to stand when you slipped up and fell back in sin. You got to stand when it's hard. You got to get back in the word and say, but this is my place in God, and I'm not moving. I don't care what wind comes. I don't care who walks out. I don't care if I don't get the job. This is my place in God, and I'm not moving. I heard the Spirit of the Lord say, tell my people to fight for their faith.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Fight. We know how to fight everywhere else. He says, take that energy and put it into fighting for your faith.
Yes.
But you can't have faith if you're not receiving it. So how do I get faith? Romans 10 and 17 says, so then faith comes by hearing, and by hearing the word of God. You don't have to answer it out loud, but how many times did you spend time in the word last week? How much time did you spend just walking around worshiping the Lord? How much time did you spend just making melodies? The Bible says, make melodies in your heart. It might not even came out verbally, but in your heart there's a song for God. How many times last week did you take time to fall on your knees and begin to read the word and pray and cry out to God? Faith comes by hearing. And hearing the word of God. How many times when you were on Facebook or Instagram or whatever, were you reading scriptures or seeking out those that were seeking out God? Fight for your faith. You can't win this fight if you lean toward the flesh all the time. And the flesh is ever present. You don't even have to lean. It's just right there. Amen? Amen. They had a man that had two dogs, and he said, which one of these you think are going to grow the most? He says, the one I feed the most. So if I feed my flesh the most with fleshly activities, that's what's growing. So if I want my faith to grow, if I want my household to be changed, if I want to walk in a different level of deliverance, if I want to not go back from the things that he's loosed me from, I got to set my face like flint and walk in faith in God. Amen. Regardless of what's come against me, regardless of how it called me, regardless of the doubt that may try to present itself in my mind, it's just a battle from the enemy. You've got to decide, I'm going to believe God.
Amen.
And he said that if we believe him, we can operate in the word. He says, and you'll know the truth. He says, if you obey the commands, you'll know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Right. So what the enemy does is he's fighting your faith that you won't even start to operate in the word. Because if you operate in the word, God gonna show up, and he gonna show out, and you gonna know he is who he says he is. And so when doubt creeps up, what also creeps up is that time that you was in that spot, and God spoke a word that you didn't even know was in this book, but then showed it to you later, but he delivered you from that spot right there in that moment without you even knowing what it said yet. Then later on, he showed it to you and say, see right there, that's what I just did. This is what I did over there when you didn't know what was happening in that place. Fight for your faith. It's a simple message this morning. Fight for it, fight for it, fight for it. If God has told you that your household is going to be blessed and that your sons and daughters are going to be orchestrating the word of God in the earth and they're going to bring hope and they're going to be joy, the Bible says that your children are blessed and your children's children, then when they're acting up, you fight with the word. I've been walking around the house saying what God took. So I said, come on now, woman of God. Call them who they are, not what they're acting like. Because I rise up to what you call me, amen. People do, don't they? If you assume a person's a certain way, that's what you get. Some of us are better because somebody else looked at us and said, you're better than that. Some of us are better because grandma said, no, baby, I can't tolerate that because anybody in this household, we not gone. So we changed because of the word spoken. We got to let the word speak in our lives. That's how you going to change, is the word. You can't do it without being in the word. You can't do it because the word is God. Amen?
Amen.
And so we got to get the word. And so when the enemy says, how do you know all that's true? Them people just put them words together. I've heard that so many times. It just makes me mad sometimes back in the days.
Yes.
How do you know it's true? Because I have seen him work a word that, like I said, I didn't even know at times. I have called out on the word of God and seen it manifest in ways I know only could be supernatural. This is the living, the breathing word of God. And I don't care who put it in the book. I know who orchestrated the story. Amen. Hallelujah. We must believe the word of God. And so even in some of the fight and some of the race relations that are going on right now, people begin to say that's the white man's book.
Uh-oh.
That book was written by these people, that it was written to suppress. So you got to get this word and let the word lead you and teach you, and you'll find out for yourself whether it's true or not. Fight for your faith. Fight for your faith. Going back, I'm still here. We're just going to stay here for a little bit. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 12. Fight the good fight of faith and lay hold on eternal life, to which you were also called and have confessed the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Can we turn to John 3:16? He says, fight for your faith. It's so precious. It's a faith that can move mountains. Amen. Fight for your faith. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We glory in you this morning. Going to John 3:16. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Can we just slow it down this morning? But God so loved you, because you're a part of this world, that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever, your name falls into whoever, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Whoever believes on him. So when I'm at home and groceries are running lower, when I'm at home and defeat sets in because I'm unemployed or I don't know what work's going to look like next month, when I'm at home and I'm frustrated with my children and they're aggravated and it seems like everything is perishing and falling apart, I can say, oh no, I have everlasting in God, life in God, and I shall not perish because of my faith. Though this outward man may be perishing day by day, the inner man, my spirit man, is being growing. It's growing and it's being renewed hour by hour. We're spiritual beings anyway, so this physical body is temporal. It's temporary, but I'm not perishing. I'm growing in God. It's not falling apart. God is mending and putting things back together, even in the midst of the season that we're in. Amen. If you would, turn with me to Romans 10. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, says John 3:16. And I just want to remind you of Timothy because it's going to connect here to Romans. Timothy 6:12 says, fight the good fight of faith. Take hold of eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Other versions say when you profess instead of confession. But the same thing, you made a sound. You said something. You said, I believe God. Amen. And we're going to read in Romans 10. We're going to start at verse 1 and read to verse 13 if the Lord says the same. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they may be saved. For I bear them witness that they have a zeal for God, but not according to knowledge. They just doing stuff to do stuff. Amen. We don't want to be there. For they being ignorant of God's righteousness and seeking to establish their own righteousness have not submitted to the righteousness of God. So there's some folks that they see that, you know, people are like and do this. And so they're doing things that sound godly, but not with the right heart or the right intent. Amen. For Christ is the end of the law. Let me go back. Amen. Verse 3. For they being ignorant of God's righteousness and seeking to establish their own righteousness have not submitted to the righteousness of God. For God is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who believes. There's that word again. Yes. Faith. Believe. Yes. Have faith. For Moses writes about the righteousness which is of the law. The man who does these things shall live by them. But the righteousness of faith speaks in this way. Do not say in your heart, who will ascend into heaven? This is to bring Christ down from above. Or who will descend into the abyss? That is to bring Christ up from the dead. But what does it say? The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. I'm going to pause there. It's in you. It's in you. The word of faith is in you. You done heard enough word where you might not have really fully comprehended it with your mind, but your spirit, man, received the word of God. Amen? And that word is in you and near you and in your mouth. So if all you know is I can do all things through Christ who strengthens you, I've learned that that covers a whole lot of area. Amen? Amen. I'm mad and I need to close my mouth. I can do it through Christ who strengthens me. Amen. I'm tired, but I need to exercise this body. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. God tells me to go do a work that I don't feel capable to do. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Amen.
So if that's all you know, that's what you lean on till you get some more. Amen. Following the word of God, because he said the word is near you. It's in your mouth and it's in your heart. The psalm says, plant your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. And so I hear you, Holy Spirit. We gotta quit fighting God. When we go to do something wrong, when he say fight, he's saying fight the good fight of faith and work alongside me.
That's right.
To bring my will to pass in the kingdom of God. Not when I whisper you and say, don't go over there today. And you go anyway. And now you chain it up. Sometimes it's erase the post. You don't have to post and comment on everybody's stuff. Amen. And sometimes we just send it on anyway. Now we entangle and stuff we don't even want to be bothered with. Amen?
Amen.
Listen to the Spirit of God. Let's not fight God. Amen. Amen. Sometimes we fight God. He's trying to send us one way and he's whispering and telling us and we just doing what we want to do. Amen. Am I the only one that's been there? Hallelujah. So we got to quit fighting God. We got to listen to the Spirit of God. Verse 8. I'm Romans 10, verse 8. But what does it say? The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. That if you confess, there's that confession, with your mouth, the Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Can we read that again? That if you confess with your mouth, you say it out loud, he's my Lord, I love him, I live for him I live, for him I die, the Lord Jesus, and believe that thing in your heart, that God has raised Jesus from the dead, you will be saved. Let's read a little bit more here. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness. You didn't say it until you believed it in here. You can't speak what you don't believe.
Amen.
Somebody that don't love you, now some we know people just spit stuff out, but someone that sincerely loves you, when they utter those words, it was here first before it came out of you. Amen. And so it was in here first. You know, many times sometimes, you know, you'll see a baby and your thoughts, oh, they're so precious. And then what comes out your mouth? They're so precious. Or it's a beautiful baby. Why? Because it was in here first. And that's why sometimes it says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. When we see stuff coming out of our mouth, we need to go to God and say, do it, it's heart issue. That could have been of you, because I heard what just came out by my father. So deal with my heart issue. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Verse 9, that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture says, whoever believes on him will not be put to shame. Whoever believes on him will not be put to shame. We're going to 13. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich to all who call on him. For verse 13, for whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Amen.
Fight for your faith.
Yes.
I don't care who else doubting. I don't care what other theory they have. We got to fight for the faith in God. Amen.
Amen.
We must fight for what we believe in. So as God took me to Timothy and he said, fight. He says, the first thing we got to do is fight the good fight of faith. Fight for this word. Fight for what we believe in.
Yes.
The second thing he said was we have to take hold of eternal life. I've given it to you. It's a free gift. This is yours. Ah, oh, what a blessing. This is yours. That all the turmoil you go through here, it's not going to continue forever. I'm going to give you some peace in this realm, but ultimately I'm taking you to glory where you'll reign in peace forever. Take hold of eternal life.
Yes.
How do I do that? By accepting Jesus and confessing with my mouth and believing in my heart that God raised him from the dead. And God says, you shall be, not might, not maybe, shall be saved. Sometimes we find it hard to exercise faith, but I noticed that this morning nobody questioned, but we just came in and said, we didn't question if the legs on the chair were going to hold us. We didn't question, you know, if they were too old or if they'd been tightened up. You know, some people say the Bible's an old book. It's no longer working. We didn't question whether the chair would hold us, if it was too old or whatever. We came in and we sat down.
Yeah.
And God wants us to exercise like that. The word says that I can sit down and rest. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord says it's working out for my good. It's a tight spot, but I can rest in God.
Amen.
Same way you came and sat in that chair. That's how you exercise faith. Well, the Lord say, I'm going to be healed. Well, since you just came in today and we see two more spots of cancer, okay. But the Lord said, I'm going to be healed.
Yes.
Fight for your faith.
Amen.
It's worth it.
Yes, it is.
It's more precious than go fight for your faith.
Uh-huh.
The enemy wants to take you out, because when you get a hold to real faith, you can bring somebody else up in faith.
That's right.
Amen.
You can tell somebody else what God has done.
Amen.
You can help them not stay in their pity party they be in. You can pull them up out of the pit. You can give them hope for another day. You can dismantle suicide thoughts. You can break the bonds of depression when you get a hold of faith. And sometimes we're breaking all that stuff right in our own house before we're doing it. But anybody else, amen? Fight for your faith.
Amen.
He says, fight the good fight of faith. Take hold of eternal life. And the third thing he showed me concerning 1 Timothy 6 and 12 is, receive the gift of God.
Amen.
You got to receive it.
Yes.
Somebody can hand you something and you can turn it down. We must receive the gift that it is just what it says it is.
Amen.
That God can do just what he said he can do.
Yes.
And I tell you what, there's not millions of people all over the globe following God because he ain't able. Amen.
Amen.
There's not people that's on their deathbed saying, but for God I live and for God I thank, bless the name of Jesus. They done seen something. They have had an encounter with the master and they realize that he's ruler over the universe. Amen.
Amen.
We have to fight for this faith in God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. If you would please turn with me to the book of Ephesians. Fight for your faith. Fight for your faith. I just have to hear the Lord say, fight, fight, fight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. We're fighting for our faith. We're going to go to Ephesians, and we're going to chapter 2. Amen. Ephesians chapter 2. So we have to receive this. Salvation, deliverance is a gift. And I just want to say, as the Lord had said before, now listen, we can't be in cahoots with the enemy and then trying to pull on God.
No.
We can't be working witchcraft at midnight.
Oh.
And then I got an issue at 6 a.m. and I want to call on the living God when I've been serving the enemy all night long.
Uh-oh.
It's not going to work. And so we have to loose the things of the world. We have to loose the gods of the world. We have to loose all of that if we want to receive God. So you might be calling God to pull you out of something, and he say, I can't pull you out because you still want to be there. Part of you is still entangled in it. Your heart has not loosed the place. Many times our heart looses the place before we fully walk into the deliverance. There's a desire just to want to be better. There's a desire to quit lying. There's a desire to quit mistreating people.
That's right.
And then when that desire comes out, we don't automatically stop doing it immediately, but every day we're seeking God because now my desire is different. But as long as our desire is for the old man and the old nature, we can't change. But listen, God said, don't wait till you get yourself together to come to me, because you won't get together.
That's right.
The only one that can put you back together again is God. Amen. The only way that you can be whole again is God. The only way you can loose the addiction is God. The only way you can quit mistreating your wife, your husband, your children is God. Hallelujah. And so don't wait to come to God because you messed up, because you're going to stay messed up. Amen.
Amen.
You must be willing to come to God as you are, because there's a desire.
Yeah.
My actions aren't completely right yet, but God, there's a desire to be better. I hadn't completely figured this thing out, but there's a desire to be better for you, God.
Yeah.
And you bring that desire before God. And you stay before the face of God, and you read the word of God concerning the situation, and he'll bring it to pass. You'll look around and realize you knew it, not even know how you got there. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because he says, behold, all things become new. Fight, fight, fight.
Yeah.
Fight for your faith. Fight for your faith. Ephesians 2, starting at chapter 1, and I'm going to verse 8. And you he made alive, who were dead in trespasses and sins.
Yes.
And which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince and the power of the air.